Find the pressure of H2O and what phase it is in, if it has a specific volume of 0.8 cubic meters per kilogram, and a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius. What is the quality X if applicable? Remember to try solving this problem yourself before watching the solution up next. This is the second example for the interpolation and mixture quality 9-minute lecture video. The links to the other examples on this topic and the other lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. Just like in most of the other examples, we start by going to the saturated mixture tables to determine the phase of our substance. In this case, the saturated mixture table by temperature. We find here that for a temperature of 150 degrees, the specific volume for a saturated vapor is 0.39. Which means that our water, which has a higher specific volume, is in a superheated phase. Therefore, we won't be finding the quality of our substance. With this information, we go to our superheated tables and look for a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius. Now, this process is slightly different to what we have been doing when interpolating. Since what we know is the rows in which our given specific volume should appear, we're not just gonna go directly to one of these subtables. We're going to look at all the different subtables and select the two that for a temperature of 150 degrees goes over and under the given specific volume of 0.8. The two pressure subtables that have a specific volume value that is around 0.8 are the 200 kilopascal one with a V equal to 0.96 and the 300 kilopascal one with a V equal to 0.63. These are above and below 0.8. Therefore, we know that our pressure must be between 200 and 300. This example shows a clearer picture of why interpolating linearly can sometimes be a bit too rough. In the TV diagrams that we've been working with, it's less noticeable. But here in a PV diagram, if we add a couple of these points here, we see the huge changes between the points that we do have. So the linear interpolation might not be that accurate. Anyways, going back to our interpolation, we know that the slope between the two points in the table is 200 minus 300 over 0.96 minus 0.63. The slope that includes our point of interest would be P minus 300 over our V, 0.8, minus 0.63. We solve for P from this equation, and find that the pressure is 249 kilopascals. If you want to check out the other examples for this same topic, the main lecture video, or other lectures of the thermo course and other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching!